So anyway, I thought I was good for like a good year, 9, 10 months. Then I had another scan. I never heard from them for a long time. And then it must have been in December, if I'm not mistaken, 2019. I may be getting my dates mixed up, or January 2020, that I got the call, and that's when the lady said that on your latest scan, we've seen something that looks a bit conspicuous, and we want to give you a PET scan. So I think they gave me a CT scan. Now they want to give me a PET scan. And they described it as it's just another way, a more detailed scan of looking at the same thing from a different angle. So they done that, and then they called me up and said, the PET scan has shown that you've got some uptake. Again, these are all terminologies. I'm like, well, what does uptake mean? What does conspicuous mean in this context? I know what conspicuous means normally, but in this con in the medical context, what does it mean? You've got some uptake, and you've got some your lymph nodes. That's what she said. Your lymph nodes appear to be, or some of your lymph nodes around your groin area, right and left, appear to be malignant. That's another fancy term for cancerous.
Oh,
So,
really?
yeah. So it was just
And she said this
like
to you on the phone.
on the phone. Should do? Are they supposed to do that or not? I don't know. Me personally, I didn't mind. I didn't mind. I'd rather know than tell me to come and face to face and
How did
wait.
that make you feel as soon as you? I know you said you had the recording, but I haven't heard it.
Yeah.
What was going through your head? Was you with your wife, your family at the
Yeah,
time?
I was. She was right next to me. My heart dropped. My heart sunk. But I've always said to myself that, the first time I went through it, I was like, if I look back and say, how did I deal with it? I dealt with it okay. Could I have been more patient? Yes. Could I have had more tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Yes. There's so many things that I could have done better looking back in retrospect. But because you're in it, you don't necessarily look at it so objectively because you're just trying to get through. So I've always said to myself, if it comes back again, then inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to show Allah that I'm going to be patient with it. So, does it get me down? Yes, I'm a human being. Do you know what I mean? Another benefit, or another something that's been, a beautiful experience that has happened on the back of me having cancer is that my son was born. I never expected when I was going through that, the crux of this trial, to ever see another child. I wanted one, but I never thought. Remember, I got told I'd never be able to use it again. To thinking I was gonna die. To, alhamdulillah, being able to perform Hajj for another time. To starting up an academy, which is educating over 60 kids. Walillah, alhamdulillah, wa shukr. To now having another baby. How can I not be grateful for what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me? Because oftentimes, akhi, when we have a blessing, or when Allah sends blessings, we never ever say, Allah, why? Why are you blessing me like this? You just say Alhamdulillah and you accept the blessing. So similarly, when we get tested, we should also adopt that same type of mindset and say Alhamdulillah, because, like I said again, Akhi, oftentimes from trauma, from stress, from frustration, beautiful things happen. And that's what we have to believe. And we just have to trust in the process. Ultimately, first and foremost, trust in Allah, trust in the process, and have that firm conviction that everything's going to be okay. And inshallah ta'ala, there's something better and greater waiting on the other side. So now that I've been re-diagnosed with cancer, I don't want to deal with it how I dealt with it before, i.e. being a recluse and staying in my house and, not mixing up with anybody and, not returning calls and stuff like that. I said, nah, this time I'm going to be the total opposite.